Chances are, whether as a pilot or passenger, you've experienced the awesome sensation of being pressed back in your seat from the powerful thrust used during takeoff on a commercial flight. Whether flying commercially or in smaller general aviation aircraft, flying truly is an amazing and incredible experience for almost everyone. That is, when everything goes just right. But what if something does go wrong on takeoff, especially in the general aviation environment? Well, unless the pilot handles the situation properly, things can turn deadly fast. Just look at the daily news for a stark reminder that tragedy can happen to anyone, regardless of their situation or their prior experience. That's pretty scary, right? Keep in mind as you watch this that statistically, flight is incredibly safe thanks to the combined experience of aircraft designers, engineers, pilots, controllers, technicians, and of course, governing agencies over more than a century. In fact, FAA and ICAO statistics show that on average, engine failure during takeoff occurs at only 0.005% of the 100,000 daily flight operations. To put that in perspective, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration data shows that you have a 0.074% chance of being in a car accident on any given day. This rate is nearly 15 times higher than that of engine failure during takeoff. Nonetheless, engine failure can and does happen for any number of reasons, which is a subject for another video. So, what do we pilots, students, and aviation enthusiasts do about it? Well, as pilots, we train a lot to be prepared for the unexpected. The engine out maneuver we'll focus on today is the hotly contested impossible turn. But wait, what is it and why is it called that? The impossible turn is a critical and often dangerous maneuver following an engine failure during takeoff when a pilot tries to make a rapid turn back to land on the same runway they just departed from, but in the opposite direction. It's called the impossible turn because in many cases, this maneuver exceeds the performance capabilities of the aircraft or the pilot, leading to a high risk of control loss, stall, crash, severe injury, and even death. With this in mind, and for our safety and demonstration purposes, we'll use Microsoft Flight Simulator to fly, execute, and analyze a typical sequence of events in a complete engine failure during takeoff, and more specifically, executing this impossible turn. A side note, Microsoft Flight Simulator is amazingly accurate in its look and feel and is a great resource to supplement approved FAA training. Today, we'll be flying the popular Cessna 172S or SP from a relatively small uncontrolled airport. It's important to note that this is a simulated environment on a clear standard day at sea level with zero wind, unlimited visibility, no passengers, and no other traffic in the pattern. These are just a few of many factors that a pilot in command must consider when making the go, no-go decision prior to every flight. Note also, the simulated engine out procedure we're conducting here is actually a rapid reduction in power by throttling back in a manner similar to power off stall maneuvers or simulated engine out procedures typically practiced in introductory flight training. A general thought to keep in mind when handling an irrecoverable engine out on takeoff and you are less than 800 feet AGL or above ground level, do not attempt the impossible turn. Execute an emergency landing either straight forward or within 60 degrees left or right of heading as conditions permit. This is to simply minimize rapid altitude loss and reduce the loading of increased bank angle and the exponential increase in the associated stall speed during steep banks. As part of your pre-flight planning, use all available resources such as ForeFlight or even Google Earth to determine safe off-field landing sites around your airfield. Also, brief and fly with a qualified CFI whenever possible. Before we go any farther, I must make the disclaimer that while I am a commercial pilot, I am not a CFI, a certified flight instructor. And the points I bring up are my own observations only and shouldn't be used for training or constitute flight safety protocol. I'll put some links to approved training resources in the description below. The FAA safety brochure P8740-44, titled The Impossible Turn, discusses the challenges and considerations associated with attempting to return to the runway after an engine failure on takeoff. The brochure emphasizes that turning back is often the worst possible action when the power plant fails during climbout in a single-engine aircraft. It highlights the significant altitude loss during the turn and the time required to execute such a maneuver, which can be underestimated by pilots, especially in the situation. The document advises that, in most cases, landing straight ahead or within a narrow sector is the safer option. Nonetheless, and a little bit surprisingly, Section A11.4 of Advisory Circular 61-83J states that flight instructors should demonstrate and teach trainees when and how to make a safe 180-degree turn back to the field following an engine failure. It's interesting because when we attempt the impossible turn, you'll notice that it's more than 180 degrees, often about 210 degrees, to get back onto your final approach course. Let's reference the Cessna 172S Pilot Operating Handbook, or POH, for the short field takeoff checklist. Note that flaps are set to 10 degrees. Apply brakes until reaching maximum RPM and release. Climb at 56 knots indicated airspeed until clear of obstacles. Then, reference the final two steps of the normal takeoff procedure by adjusting climb speed to 70 to 80 knots and retracting flaps. Let's look at the emergency procedures checklist for engine failure immediately after takeoff. This is a good time to review the checklist, as you will definitely not have time to do it if the event actually occurs during takeoff. Just keep in mind the four Fs. First, fly the plane. And although the impossible turn is not listed in the POH, note that indicated airspeed with flaps up is 70 knots and 65 knots with 10 degrees flaps. That can be challenging to maintain in a 210 degree turn back to the field. Okay, let's put you in the left seat and fly this thing. Know that as our flight begins, we will cut power at 700 feet, so be prepared. Remember also that the altimeter indicates altitude in MSL or mean sea level, not AGL or above ground level. Our airfield is 34 feet above sea level, so in this case, the indicated MSL altitude is almost the same as AGL. By the way, our flight controls are the Logitech Pro Flight Yoke Throttle and Pedal System. So welcome aboard. You're cleared for takeoff. I'll critique along the way. Have a safe flight. We have 10 degrees flaps and are slightly right of runway centerline. We release brakes a bit early. Make sure the RPMs come up fully before releasing. That's a good rotation speed. And at this field, we're already clear of obstacles, so adjust climb speed to 70 knots, and we'll retract flaps at 300 feet. Maintain runway heading. Watch that airspeed between 70 and 80 knots. Uh-oh, we just lost power. Make a steep banking coordinated turn and push the nose steeply down. Hear that? That was the stall horn. Step on the ball. Good job. We're now at 80 knots. We've already lost 250 feet. Now level out and maintain 65 to 70 knots. Step on the ball. Good job. Runway's in sight. We're back in coordinated flight, but watch that airspeed. 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 We haven't put 10 degrees in and you're below 60 knots. But in this simulated emergency scenario, you get a little leeway. Keeping in mind, your stall speed is now 48 knots. When you're confident you made the runway and have good airspeed, add flaps as necessary. In the landing configuration, your stall speed is 40 knots, so you're incredibly close, but still above it. Hear that stall horn? Now apply brakes. Retract flaps. Success, but only in our simulated environment. Now let's watch this whole thing again, slightly accelerated, with some exterior and overhead views. do you think of the impossible turn? Does it work, or is it just way too risky? Remember, any landing you walk away from is a good landing. Your safety and survival matter a lot more than a perfect touchdown or even the aircraft itself. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video or learned something from it, give us a thumbs up and share it. And share your thoughts in the comment section below. Safe flight.